All right, workout worthy, welcome to Total Body Conditioning. This is a quick, effective, complete full body workout that's going to get your cardio, your strength, and your core all done at once. Make sure you subscribe to this channel, like this video, and save this video. Your workouts do not need to be extreme, but you do need to be consistent. And strength training 2 to 3 days a week is going to help you maintain and obtain your health and wellness goals. Now, if you are already warm, skip ahead to section one. If not, we're gonna do a quick warm up together. We have 5 sections today, and it's gonna be about a 35 to 40 minute workout. Let's march it out with your right leg. Back is tall, abs are tight. Nice long neutral spine, nice strong core. Take a deep breath, inhale up and exhale. Now side to side, right and left. Wide knee lifts out. So the warm up is the only choreographed part of class. We want to get the heart rate elevated, the blood pumping, muscles ready to work. 4, 3, 2. Now hamstring curls. Gentle stretch across your chest. Gentle stretch through your quads. 4, 3. Wide knee lifts. Out. 4, 3, 2. Now hamstring curls back. Wide knees for 4, 3. Hamstring curls for 4, 3. Wide knee lifts for 4, 3. Hamstring curls, 4, 3. Side to side, right and left. Change this to a two-step. Two to your right, two to your left. Great five. Step behind, step behind. We're gonna stay with this grapevine. Grapevine with a knee. Grapevine with a curl. Stationary knees for 4, 3, 2. Hamstrings for 4, 3, 2. Half squats, right and left. Weight is in both heels, reaching your hips back. Like you're sitting in a chair just a little too far away while keeping your chest lifted. 2 count jacks, nice and slow, out and in. This is a little bit higher impact. So if you need less, do your half squats, but up on your tiptoes. We wanna wake up the arches, the heels, the calves. Singles, 2 sets of 8. Single jumping jacks, nice and strong. No impact, might be a heel kick. You might do a heel with a hop. We're gonna finish the warm up, taking it from the top. Grapevine with a knee. Grapevine with a curl. Stationary knees, 4. Hamstring curls for 4. Half squats, right, left. Inhale and exhale. 4, 3, 2. 2 count jumping jacks for 8. High impact or less impact. 4 more. 4, 3, 2. Single jacks, 2 sets of 8. Strong and steady. No impact, still a great warm-up option. Heel with a hop. 4, 3, 2, march it out. Okay, so each section, we have 5 sections today. Grab a drink, towel off, keep moving. It's gonna start with cardio. Jumping jacks, like the warm-up, but more intensity, 30 seconds. We ready? Here we go, 30 seconds. High impact might be little fast movements, might be bigger movements. No impact, middle impact, you decide. Intensity is the goal. So first you choose your impact, then your range of motion, in good form of course, and then you sprint as fast as you can go for this 30 second interval. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. And done. are back. Bending your knees, lifting your legs. You want the heaviest weight that you can do in good form. Hinging for wide bend back rows. Pull for two. Control for two. Exhale as you lift. Inhale as you lower. So we're hinged at the hips. Our knees are soft. We've got a neutral spine, stabilizing through our core and our lower body. Contract the back to lift the dumbbells. Keeping your shoulders low and relaxed. Neck is long and lean. Elbows are pulling out wide. Exhale up. Single bent back rows. Pull, pause, lift, lower. If this feels too fast, slow it down. Go at your own pace. This is a back strength exercise, so we care more about good form, challenging our muscle, than we care about speed. 16 is the maximum number of single reps you're gonna do, but you might do 13, you might do 10. Inhale and exhale, deadlifts, lower body. You might use the same weight, you might need to carefully adjust. Legs are hip width apart, knees are soft. Hinging at the hip with a neutral spine, letting your arms hang, and then digging your heels into the floor, using your legs to stand back up. Two counts, hinge for two, squeeze for two. Resist the stretch, contract the legs. Inhale, exhale. So this really starts with good leg position. Knees are soft, not bending, not extending, focusing on the hip hinge as the leg movement. We've got a neutral spine from our tailbone through the crown of our head. We do not want to round our back, and we do not want to arch. Shoulder blades stay retracted, like you're holding a pencil between your shoulder blades, allowing your arms to hang without letting your back round. Inhale and exhale. Don't just go through the motions. Think about resisting the stretch, digging your heels into the floor, and contracting your inner thighs, your hamstrings, and glutes. You can stay at this pace, which I love, or you can do singles, up to eight singles, eight or less. Seven, so if I do singles, I'm not going as deep, but I'm keeping good form. If I wanna keep that range of motion, I'm just gonna go a little bit slower than that single tempo pace. Great job, combo. Dead rows, you're only as strong as your weaker muscle group. So if you did use different weight for each exercise, go with the lighter of the two. We're gonna do a deadlift, hold for a back row, and then contract, two counts. Here we go, hinge for two, row for two, control for two, contract the legs, resist the stretch, contract the back, control the weight, contract the legs, keeping our best form for each movement. Four distinct movements without bouncing, without jerking. It's strong and smooth. Inhale, exhale, inhale, singles. Hinge, row, control, contract. Legs, back, back, legs. Keeping our chin level, our neck long, shoulders low and relaxed. Two more sets of eight. Legs, back, back, legs. No swinging, no using momentum. At the top, you can squeeze your glutes, but do not arch your back. Your shoulders stop in line with the middle of your hips, not your butt. If your shoulders go back to your butt, you're going to be arching, and we don't want that. Keep breathing. Inhale and exhale. Legs, back, back, legs. Hinge, pull, control, contract. Inhale, exhale. Four more, or less. Remember, you can always slow it down if you need to. Three, four, or less. Last two, last one. Legs, back, back, legs. Okay, one dumbbell, or your body weight. We are gonna do alternating lateral lunges. So legs as wide as you can go without sliding into a split, squeezing your heels to the floor. Goblet hold, we're gonna alternate sides. This is based on time, not speed. So go at your own pace. These are stationary alternating lunges. Your knees follow the angle of your toes. That is so important. Your straight leg is straight, but it's not hyperextended. We're not locking that knee joint. Keep it soft, even though it's straight. Hips stay level, chest stays level, shoulders stay level. You get the idea here. Not leaning, not tilting. It is still a strength move. Lower body, adductors, those inner thighs, abductors, those outer hips, glutes, quads, hamstrings, this move does it all. Fast enough is a challenge, not so fast that you use momentum. Working the core to stabilize, to prevent movement. Upper body's got that goblet hold. 5 seconds, 4, 3, 2, 1, and done. Standing core, let's do marches. Dumbbells are optional. If you do want dumbbells, do two. So I'm doing two of my light ones. 30 seconds, standing march. Knuckles up to the ceiling. Arms can stay here or extend. Trying not to lean, trying not to wobble side to side. If you're extending your arms, don't break your wrist. Keep them neutral. Elbows are straight, but soft. We don't want to be here. We want extension. Shoulders low and relaxed. Neck is long and lean. Neutral spine, so those natural curves stay in your back. Keep breathing. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Grab a drink, towel off, round two. So with this next round, if you need to stay upright, you're gonna do jumping jacks again. If you can go to the floor, we're gonna do jacks in plank. The hardest plank you can do in good form. You can do one leg at a time, or you can jump. Cardio's the goal. Here we go, 30 seconds. Long neutral spine, belly sucking up towards the spine. Breathing, and these can be little and fast. Maybe you're going wider. Keep that neutral spine the entire time, and that includes your neck. Chin is level, not looking up, not looking down, and we're not lunging our face to the floor. Belly sucking up, flexing the core, keeping that length. 5 seconds left. 4, 3, 2, 1, and done. Okay, strength. If you need to stay upright, you are going to do push-ups on the wall. If you can come to the floor, we're going to do chest press. So chest is the muscle we're strengthening. Heaviest weight you can do in good form. I'm staying with my heavies. Dumbbells are above your shoulders, not your face. Make sure you're breathing. Two counts. Inhale as you lower. Exhale as you press. Inhale as you lower. Exhale as you press. Keeping the shoulders low and relaxed. Elbows hover at the bottom and then power back up with those chest muscles contracting. Rib cage is pulled down, abs are tight, core is working, and keep the neutral wrist. Don't push through your palms, press through your knuckles, such a big difference. Singles, 2 sets of 8, maximum number of reps, but you might do less. Don't let the dumbbells drop, control that bend. Stop momentum, reverse direction, and power up. 8, 7, inhale, exhale. 4, 3, 2, 1. Lower body, glute bridges. You only need one dumbbell, so I'm gonna sit one on the side. Extra sit up there, do it safely. Dumbbell is on your hip bones. If you are standing, you're gonna do deadlifts again. If you're on the mat, you're gonna do 2-count glute bridges. Squeeze up, then lower to a hover. Squeeze up, lower to a hover. Digging your feet into the floor, contracting your inner thighs, your hamstrings, and your glutes. Core is strong. The highest you wanna go would be a straight line from your knees to your hips to your shoulder blades. You don't wanna go higher and arch your back, but lower is fine. You can stay at this pace for singles. Lift, hover, lift, hover. Inhale, exhale. Contract, control. Lift and lower. Inhale,
Exhale, we're halfway. 8 or less. 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Great job, combo. If you are upright, you're going to do push-ups again. If you're on the floor, we're going to do chest press with glute bridges. Arms above your shoulders. Lift to the glute bridge. Body weight only for the glutes. Chest, dumbbells. Here we go. Lower to a hover. Contract up. Combo move. Keeping your good form of both exercises. Lower body, isolating the inner thighs, hamstrings, and glutes. Upper body, isolating the chest. Core is working to stabilize and move both. Inhale. And exhale. Inhale. You can stay at this pace or singles. Cover, push. Cover, push. Inhale. Exhale. Not bouncing, not using momentum. This is all muscle contraction. We are halfway. 8, 7. If it feels too fast, slow it down. Focus on good form. Final 4, 3, 2, 1. Now we're gonna do our 30 seconds of core here on the floor. If you are standing, you're gonna do those standing marches once again. If you're on the floor, I'm gonna drop to one weight, my lightest, my 5, and we're gonna do a double crunch, 30 seconds. Here we go. Double crunch, knees are bent, overhead to your ankles. With a dumbbell is an option. With your hands is an option. And if you need support, you can bring your fingertips behind your ears. If moving your legs does not work for you, stay with a basic crunch, with or without that overhead movement. 10 seconds. Isolating your core. Moving fast enough is a challenge, but not so fast you use momentum or bad form. Great job. Section 2 is almost complete. We have one exercise left, those lateral lunges. One dumbbell, and this is optional. You can stay stationary, but if you do stationary, what you want to do is stay on one side, 30 seconds. If you add movement, we're going to do 30 seconds on each leg. You ready? Here we go. Towards your right, power up. Lateral lunge, still with the goblet hold. So important, your right knee follows the angle of the right toes. Left leg is straight, but the knee is soft. Our knees bend, they don't twist. So no twisting through the knee joint. Hips stay level, shoulders stay level. A little bit more of a hip hinge now that we're adding the side movement. All right, switch sides. 30 seconds. Stationary is an option, and it's never a bad idea to do a couple stationary to make sure you're in good form. If you add that movement, it should add a challenge without negatively affecting your form. Keep breathing, halfway. Almost done with section 2. Five, four, three, two, one. Round 3, grab a drink, towel off. We're gonna start with jumping jacks. 30 seconds, cardio burst in 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Here we go. 30 seconds, jumping jacks. Shoulders low and relaxed. Choose your impact. Remember, no impact is an option. Once you choose your impact, then choose your range of motion, bigger or smaller. Then we sprint as fast as we can go the entire interval. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, and done. Upper body, shoulders. We're gonna do a narrow shoulder press. I'm gonna go with my middle weights. Big shoulder roll, great posture, knuckles to the ceiling. Press for 2. Bend for 2. So from this front angle, knees are soft, hips are level, shoulders are level. Push your shoulders down as you extend your arms, keeping a neutral wrist, elbows in line. Exhale up.
So evenly distributing stress down our spine, not arching, but also not rounding. 90s at the elbows, try to stop parallel. Exhale, singles. Two sets of eight is the most. Even though I went lighter with my dumbbells than I did for my back and my chest, this is still a really hard exercise. The narrow grip is harder for me than a wide grip. And we're going overhead. So slow down your speed if you need to. Focus on shoulder strength. Inhale. Exhale. Four. Three. Two. And one. Lower body, we're gonna do squats. Legs, I'm gonna go a little heavier. Bending your knees, lifting your legs if you have to adjust. Hip to shoulder width apart, but a little more narrow. Toes are still angled out, but just barely. Knees follow your toes. Two count squat, down for two, up for two. So knees follow the angle of your toes, not buckling in, not wobbling out. Hips reach back like you're sitting in a chair a little too far away, but belly button faces forward, not the floor, even at the bottom of your squat. Chin is level. We're not lifting our chin to look forward. We're not tucking our chin and looking at the floor. Head is an extension of our spine. You can stay here or singles. Two sets of eight. Now I'm going really deep into my squat. So I know my speed is gonna have to slow down a little bit. Instead of 16 singles, I might do 12 or 13 singles, and that is more than fine. Eight or less. Seven, keep breathing. Inhale and exhale. Four, three, two, and one. Combo time. Only as strong as your weaker muscle group. And this one's gonna be hard. So you might even go lighter than you did when you did shoulders alone. We're gonna add the squat with the shoulder press. My count, two count, nice and slow. Squat for two, lift for two. Inhale, exhale, down. Power up, leg strength, shoulder strength, core strength to stabilize. We're moving big ranges of motion, lots of muscles involved. Inhale, exhale, inhale, singles. Two sets of eight is the max. I am definitely going slower than the music. That is more than fine. Go at your own pace. Inhale, exhale. Inhale, halfway, eight or less. Seven, press through the knuckles, do not push through your palms. Fight for every rep. Four, three, two, one. Whew, all right, lateral lunges, one dumbbell. Let's go to the left side first. You can go stationary, you can add the movement, or you can add a reach. 30 seconds starting now. Nothing else changes in your form. If you are stationary, it's the same movement as if you were moving. And stationary, you could do this. You could add the reach without the movement. You could add the movement without the reach. Or you can do it all. Try not to lean, try not to tilt. Your hips are still level, which means those inner and outer hips have to work hard. Switch sides, you ready? 30 seconds, stationary. Stationary with a reach. Movement, movement with a reach. Exploring that range of motion, inner thigh, outer hip, hamstring, glutes, core, upper body as well. As you can see, we got 5 seconds left. Four, three, two, and one. Set the weight down. Okay, core, standing marches. One dumbbell or two. I'm gonna use one dumbbell this time. 30 seconds and then we're done with this section. Standing marches. This is option one. This is option two. Good form, no wobble, belly sucking in towards our spine. Shoulders low and relaxed. Arms are straight. Elbows are soft, but they're not bent. Minimize that movement side to side. Don't worry about how high your knee gets. Worry about that core stability. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, and done. Grab a drink. Towel off if you need to. I know I do. Keep moving. Cardio. If you need to stay upright, you're gonna do standing jacks. Otherwise, jacks on the floor. Second and final. Here we go. 3, 2, 1. One leg at a time. If you want less impact, both legs, a little bit higher impact. Holding plank might be enough. This is your cardio burst. You want to get that heart rate elevated, it might already be there. Chin is level, neck is long, shoulders are low and relaxed. Keep breathing. 10 seconds left, keep it up. Five, four, three, two, one, and done. Upper body. If you are staying upright, you are gonna do overhead tricep extensions. If you are on the floor, you're gonna do skull crushers. Support yourself down. Long neck, strong core. I'm a little lighter than I did for my chest. My triceps can't be that heavy. Pressing the dumbbells together is a great way to stabilize. Shoulder width apart adds a stability challenge. Triceps is the goal though. Don't hit your head. Bend and then contract. Inhale, exhale. Shoulders are low and relaxed. They do not move. Elbows are right above your shoulders and they do not move in space. We bend the elbows without letting them lower to our rib cage. We bend the elbows without letting them go towards our face. Parallel is the deepest you would go, but you don't need to go that deep. Singles, harder to stabilize. Rib cage pulled down, abs are tight. Harder to stabilize through the shoulders as well. Pause, pause, bend, extend, control, contract. We're halfway. Slow it down if you need to. Dumbbell shoulder width apart is an option, but you can press the dumbbells together as well. Be aware of where the dumbbell is. Do not let it hit your head. Two more, and one. Good. Glute bridges. If you are upright, you are gonna do deadlifts one final time. If you are on the floor, heaviest weight you can do in good form, just the lower body, focusing on the inner thighs, hamstrings, and glutes. Lift for two, lower to the hover. Lift for two, lower to the hover. Exhale, and inhale, exhale, inhale. Great job, four more, slow, earn every inch. It's not a big range of motion, but you're controlling every inch of the movement from the top to the hover. Exhale, singles, contract, control, lift and lower. Inhale, exhale, leg strength, making this movement happen, core strength, stabilizing while we do. Eight or less, seven, six, five, four, three, two, one, combo. Tricep weight is what you're gonna wanna pick, so I'm going with my middles, just as a reference. Lower body is going to be body weight only, and if you're upright, you're going back to the triceps overhead. Two counts. So we bend, hover, contract, up. Lower to that hover. Good form. We cannot compromise form for either of these moves just because we're connecting them and doing them together. Inhale and exhale. Lower to a hover, contract back up. Lower to a hover, contract back up. You can stay at this pace or single. Hover, lift. Now, if you want to hold here instead, that's a great option. If your legs need a break, you can do your arms only. If your arms need a break, you can do your legs only. This is your workout.
eight, seven. If it feels too fast, slow it down. Four, three, two, one. Core. We're going to do our 30 seconds of core before we do our lateral lunges, because you know they're coming. Dumbbell is optional. If you use a dumbbell this time, squeeze it between your knees. We're going to do a double crunch, 30 seconds, meeting in the middle. Then we hover. Elbows are out nice and wide. Now, you can do both if you wanted. Let's do that. If you wanted a dumbbell in your hand and between your knees, that is a great option. If you wanted it just in your hands and not between your knees, that is a great option as well. So many combinations. Choose the option that works for you, that you can do safely, but it's a little outside your comfort zone, a little challenge. Your speed is fast enough that it's challenging, but not so fast that you use momentum. Whew, all right. Lateral lunges, and we are done with our fourth section. Heaviest weight you can do in good form. I'm gonna go with my middles, and you'll see why in a minute. Anything we've done so far is a choice. Stationary, reach, we're gonna add a press, 30 seconds. So you can do a reach to a press with movement. Maybe you wanna do the reach with a press without movement. That works too. Maybe you don't want that press. We did a lot of shoulders already. 30 seconds on this side. We've got 10 more. It's not about speed. This isn't our cardio. This is really inner thigh, outer hip, hamstring and glute, along with your core and heart rates up. Switch sides. 30 seconds. Final part of this fourth section. And then we start our final section. Almost there. Lateral lunge, with or without a reach, with or without a press, with or without movement. Five, four, three, two, and one. Grab a drink, towel off. Final section, we're gonna start with cardio. Jumping jacks. March in place, move around. It's our last section, last cardio burst. Five, four, three, two, here we go. 30 seconds, no impact. And for me, the impact isn't the issue at the moment. My shoulders are tired. So I'm gonna do a smaller range of motion with my arms, but I'm choosing the higher impact to make up for it. And as always, I'm going as fast as I can. Keep breathing, halfway. Last section, last cardio burst. Outside your comfort zone, finish strong. Four, three, two, one. Upper body, bicep curls. And right from go, we are gonna connect these with lunges. So bend your knees, lift with your legs. Right leg forward, left leg back. Hips are square. We are only doing one set on each side, and we're combining, but first, stationary lunge, down for two, up for two. Just the legs, chest is open, great posture, not arching our back, not tucking our hips. Keeping that neutral spine. Two counts, but add the curl. We lunge for two, curl for two. Lunge for two, curl for two. Lunge for two, curl. Lunge for two, curl. Singles. Breathing. No momentum here. We're not swinging the arms. We control the extension. Contract to lift the dumbbell. Inhale, exhale. It's our only set on this side for the lunges. Inhale, exhale. We got four more combos, but we're not gonna stop here. Give me two more combos. Just the legs for eight, seven. Inhale, exhale. 4, 3, 2, and 1. Bring it up. Left leg, same set. Left leg forward, right leg back. Wide stance, 2 counts, just the legs. Lunge for 2, lift for 2. Lunge for 2, lift for 2. Down, up, down, up. Add the arms, keep it slow and strong. Slow and strong. 2 more combos, slow, curl, slow, curl. Singles, lower, lift. Now we already did these arms once. So if you have to choose, focus on the legs first. Do the arms combo if you can. Breathing. 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Just the legs for 8, 7, 6. Ooh, losing my balance. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. So close. 1 dumbbell. Marching. Stand in marches for our core. 30 seconds. You can hold here. You can hold here. You can pull in if you want a little bit extra. 30 seconds. No matter your choice, sucking the belly in, flexing through the core. Halfway. Five, four, three, two, one, and done. Lateral lunges. Last set, I'm gonna stay with my middle. Do our left side first, we have 1 minute left. If you need more, the final option is gonna be to balance at the top. Here we go, 30 seconds. Stationary, with or without a reach. Moving or stationary, with or without a press. And then that knee lift balance as our final option. Halfway, 15 seconds on this side. 5, 4, 3, 2, switch sides. Lateral lunge. Now that knee might not add value. It adds stability challenge, but do the option that you get the most out of, that you can keep the best form with. Halfway, 15 seconds. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, and done. Grab a drink, towel off, and march in place. Doesn't matter which leg. Keep moving. Take a nice deep breath, inhale. And exhale, nice deep breath, inhale. And exhale, side to side, right and left. March it out, nice deep breath, side to side, right and left. March it out. Fantastic job, workout worthy. That was a complete full body workout. Cardio, strength, and core. Your exercise is done for the day. If you want to add a little bit of plyo for a stretch, if you want to go for a walk, enjoy the rest of your day. Your workouts should energize you, not exhaust you. Subscribe to this channel, like this video, and come back anytime.